नमस्ते, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। आई एम JBN डॉक्टर नामिका अहरवार, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी एट ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेक द लेक्चर ऑन द सब्जेक्ट नेम इंट्रोडक्शन टू डेटा साइंस। द टॉपिक ऑफ टुडे सेशन इज डेटा रैंगलिंग। दीज आर द टॉपिक्स विच आई हैव कवर्ड इन दिस सेशन। What is data wrangling? What is the purpose of data wrangling? Key steps in data wrangling process, data wrangling machine learning algorithms, how data wrangling solves major big data machine learning challenges, and the last is data wrangling tools. What is data wrangling? Data wrangling is also known as data munging. And it is the process of basically transforming data from its original raw form into a more digestible format and organizing sets from various sources into a singular coherent whole for further processing. Right? You can see in this diagram, here you can see the data in which evaluation. This evaluation part transforming into the business understanding, of course. We need to prepare data. Then after preparing the data, you have to prepare the model. Then after, you go back to the further data preparation for the further process, and after preparing this data preparation, if you are preparing this model phase, then you need to evaluate it. Then after evaluation, the data transform to the business understanding, for business understanding purpose, you can say, right? So after evaluation, you have to deploy. Okay, so this is all about data wrangling. Now the question is, what is raw data? You can say any repository data, text, images, databases, records that is documented but still to be processed and fully integrated into the system. So the wrangling process can be described as digesting data, often referred as I told you, munging. Thus the alternative term is, you can say, data munging, and makes it useful for the system, right? So it can be, you can say, described as a stage of preparation for any other data related operation. Data wrangling is generally accomplished by mapping, and this data mapping refers to a wrangling process elements that involve identify the source data field in their respective target field data fields. So while wrangling is dedicated to the transformation of data, mapping it about connecting dots between different elements. Now the next is, what is the purpose of data wrangling? The primary purpose of data wrangling can be described as getting data in coherent shape. Or you can say, in other words, it is making raw data usable. It provides substance for further proceeding. And as such, data wrangling acts as a preparation stage for the data mining operation. Process-wise, these two operations, what is raw data usable and that preparation stage. Okay, so these two operations are coupled together, as you can't do one without another. Because without raw data, you cannot prepare anything, okay? Now comes to the key steps in data wrangling process. Data acquiring is most important thing in the data wrangling process. Of course, acquiring data, this is the first step, and it is the most important step in acquiring and sorting data. or we can say that finding your data to investigate it further might be the most crucial step towards reaching your goal of answering your questions. So, however, before finding data, you must know the following properties and you must be okay with that, because this is just the start of a tedious process. You can say not all the all data is created equal. Means while we would like to believe in the truthfulness and accuracy of the data, we see not all the data would meet our standards. When you first explore data, you need to ask yourself a small set of questions like, is the source author available? If I have any question or concern, okay. So what we will do if I have any question, okay. So you have to check the availability. And the second is does the data tends to be updated regularly, and does it includes details as to how it was obtained and what kind of samples were used for its acquisition. And the last you can say is there any other source where the data can be verified? So if the answers to these or more questions is yes, okay, so then you are on the right track. But if the answer of one or two question is no, you have to dig a little deeper into it. Now this second is the fact checking your results, even if it is irritating most of the time, okay. So of course it is a crucial to the quality of your study. If you have access to any of the resources such as Lexis or Nexus, Cornell universities at EXIF projects, Google Scholar Quest, and Google's newly released Data Quest, you can learn what others have learned and used in the project or research projects. So once you have authenticated and checked your data, it will be easier to access its validity in the future, right? So the next you can say where to find the data. This is also important thing, okay. So it's obvious that you are not going to ring everyone's phone to collect data, just like there are numerous sources of verify your data. There are large number of sources from which you can obtain your data. So that's include government data, okay, NGO data, educational or university data, medical research data, crowdsource data, and so on, okay. So know the best access to locate data set for data science ventures. So after that we have to go to the next step, that is data cleaning. This is also the important step. Cleaning up data is not more of the glamorous task, but it is an essential part of data wrangling, okay. So to become a data cleaning expert, you must have precision knowledge of a particular field, and on top of that, patience is most important for doing data cleaning step, okay. So moving towards technical side, Python can help you clean your data easily, assuming that you have a basic knowledge of Python. So you can say Python of course is important to learn, okay. So in this data clean a basis, like we need data to perform operations, okay. So here we will use UNICEF data collection relevant to child labor, and let me give you some insights into the results. Early data sets include multiple indicator cluster surveys, that is MIS,
Such surveys are household surveys conducted by UNICEF staff and volunteers to help study the living conditions of women and children around the world. So, given at the most recent survey, we extracted some data from Zimbabwe's new MIS for studies, and you are going to find the updated CSVs here, okay? So, identify the software cleanup projects and this formatting data. Formatting data means what the this is the most popular aim of data cleanup is to get the unreadable or hard to read data to be found in the correct readable format, right? So Python gives us a lot of way to format strings and numbers. So we need to use the person that shows the Python represents representations of an object in a string or Unicode to test and display our results. Python also has a %s and %d string formatter, which represent strings and digits respectively. So they are also used with the print instructions. So the format method of Python is advanced, which according to the official documentation helps one to define a string and transfer the data as arguments or keyword arguments to the string. Take a closer look at the format. Like if you are using code in Python, you need to write for body and footer, okay? So next comes to the finding outliers. In this finding outliers, we outlier means what that the thing which is not in that area, so we call it as a outlier, okay? So seeking poor data or strangers is potentially one of the most challenging job nowadays. So you do have to bear in mind that you need to clean up the data and not exploit it, okay? So for example, our UNICEF survey data set follows a standard question format, right? So this is a good sign that the data is a good sample, but then if we find that volunteers only interviewed families in urban areas and left rural areas, this could result in an error of selection or sampling based on your sources. So you can decide what bias your data set may have. Of course, apart from discovering which data bias is being used, you can find outliers by simply, if not statements, but they struggle most of the time in large data sets. Like for example, if the research our entire data set for missing data by if not statements, it would look like this, but you are not going to find any significant missing data points. Okay, so the next is data wrangling machine learning algorithms. The following types of machine learning algorithms are at play. First is the supervised machine learning algorithms. These are used for standardizing and consolidating disparate data sources. And in this supervised machine learning algorithms, classification is used to identify known patterns because it is supervised, okay? So normalization is used to flatten the independent variables of data sets and restructure data into more cohesive forms. And the second is unsupervised machine learning algorithms. These are used to exploration of unlabeled data.
In this, clustering is used to detect distinct patterns. Now come to the how data wrangling solves major big data machine learning challenges. The first is data exploration. The most important consequence of data mapping is the data processing project is exploratory. This helps to understand what kind of data you have and what you should do with it, right? So while it seems rather obvious, more often than not, this stage is skewed for the sake of seemingly more efficient manual approaches. Unfortunately, these methods also leave out and skip a lot of useful insights into the essence and structure of the data. In the end, you will be required to do it correctly to make more data processing operations feasible. So, automated data wrangling goes through data in a variety of ways and provides many more information that can be of interest to business operations, right? And the second one is unified and structured data. Of course, it's safe to say that data still comes in as a beautiful mess of various sizes and shapes. Although you might have a sense of knowing what it is and what it is for, data as it is in its original form, raw data is largely worthless if it is not structured correctly beforehand. So data wrangling and subsequent visualization of data segments and frames in a manner that would better serve its purpose. So this makes data set freely accessible for the purpose of gaining some insights into the developing mission. On the other hand, clearly structured data makes it possible to large several data sets and slowly makes the systems more efficient. Second, the next one is the data cleaning up from noise, errors, missing information. Noise, error and missing values are normal in any data set. Okay, so there are a variety of explanations for this, like human error, so-called SOPI, or unintended mislabeling, technological glitches. So it's a fact of on the efficiency of data processing operations is well known, lead to low efficiency of results and consequently to less productive business operations. And noisy data is much worse for machine learning algorithm. And if these data sets are educated in an algorithm, they can be made and useless for its purpose. So that's why the data wrangling is there to the right of the wrongs and to make it the way it was meant to be. So in the form data cleaning wrangling is performed. Okay, like audit, process specification and execution and the post-processing control. Okay, so the last is minimize data leakage. Data leakage is also considered to be the one of the greatest problems in machine learning. And since machine learnings are used for data processing, the threat is increasing exponentially. So the thing is, prediction relies on the accuracy of the data. And if the measured prediction is based on unknown data, this prediction is as good as wild guess. Now the question is, what is data leakage? The term applies to the situation where the training of the predictive models uses data outside the training data set. So-called outside evidence may be something unverified or unmarked for data training. So the direct consequence of this is an inaccurate algorithm that makes you inaccurate results that may have a significant impact on you. And
why is this happening? The typical trigger is a chaotic data structure with no simple boundary signals where what is and what is for what. The most popular form of data leakage is when data from the test set is bleeded into the training data set. So you can say extended data wrangling and data mapping techniques will be helping to mitigate its capacity and ultimately to neutralize its effect.
Now comes to the data wrangling tools. There are some basic data munging tools like Excel, Power Query, Spreadsheets, OpenRefine, Google Data Preparation, this is for exploration, cleaning and preparation, and Tabula, and the Data Wrangler, this is for also data cleaning and transformation, CSV Kit for data converting. Data wrangling in Python, you can use NumPy and Pandas. This is you can say Eka numerical Python. This is the most basic package. NumPy is the most basic package. There are lots of features for operations on an arrays and matrices in Python. So the library provides vectorization of mathematical operations on the NumPy array type, which improves performance and accordingly speeds up the execution. And the pandas are designed for fast and easy data analysis operations. So useful for data structures with label access, explicit data alignment, prevents common errors that results from misaligned data coming in different sources. Matplot library, this is a Python visualization model, and this is the perfect for line graphics, pie graphics, histograms and other technical grade numbers. Plotty, this is for interactive publication quality graphics, excellent for line plots, scatter plots, area charts, bar charts, etc. And Tino, a library for numerical computation close to NumPy. This library is designed to efficiently describe, optimize and evaluate mathematical expressions which involve multidimensional arrays. Now come to the data wrangling in R. In this, first is DPLYR. It is essential for data munching R package, supreme data framing tool, especially useful for operating on data by category. The next is PUR. It is good for list function operations and error checking. The next is the split stack shape. This is an oldie but goldie, good for shaping complex data sets and simplify the visualization. JS Online, it's a nice and easy parsing tool. And Magritter, good for wrangling scattered sets and putting them into more coherent form. This is all about today's session, and this is a question for practice. What type of users do you see wrangling data and leveraging machine learning? To what end, what capabilities do you consider important in a data wrangling technology? Thank you. This session powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. Hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you.